Hello friends, welcome to this year's online Friends and Neighbors Evening.
As some of you may know, this video grew out of the tradition that some Hutterites have of inviting their friends and neighbors for an evening of fellowship, music, and a shared meal. This video can't replace those rich in-person gatherings, but instead brings you a virtual evening of music, songs, uplifting messages, and, we pray, some Christmas hope.
This year's video features Hutterites from Manitoba, Saskatchewan, and South Dakota. You'll see beautiful Christmas artwork created by Hutterite artists and hear a variety of musical styles and song selections, as well as Christmas messages reflecting the diversity within the Hutterite world. You'll hear voices from all ages, young and old, reflecting the intergenerational families that make up our communities. Think of this video as a beautiful patchwork quilt, bringing together the unique contributions of many different communities and individuals.
The story of Christmas is the story of God's great love for each one of us. It is God coming to the lowest place. God in Jesus empties himself of divine power by being born as a helpless baby. Beautiful things happen when we empty ourselves and make space for others to bring forward their gifts. This is true not only for making a Christmas video, but also for our relationships with family, friends, and neighbors. It is my hope that this Christmas video can be a small blessing to you and yours. May it bring you some joy, some peace, and some hope.
From our communities to you, we wish you a blessed and Merry Christmas.
Yes. Learning. Welcome, friends. We hope this special time of Advent finds you all well, and in its busyness, it still allows a place and a space for peace and some quiet reflection, and that the messages you've been hearing provide some hope and inspiration on your journeys. And as we think through and ponder the message of the season, of God's gift of love and peace on earth, goodwill towards men, we pray that these Beatitudes fill our hearts and minds anew. And yet, as the season is celebrated, familiar songs and carols are sung, we are still in deep lament that our world is deeply troubled and still groaning, and that the will of its true King is far from being carried out in our world. And after thousands of years, it still has not understood this simple message of peace and conflict and human calamities, if anything, have worsened. And even so, we are urged on by our church's tradition, the prophets, the writings in our scriptures, to continue God's holy work of being beacons of hope and peacemakers in our world. And like Jesus, also offer to go to dark spaces. These places are often closer to us than we realize. They are places void of hope and justice and kindness, empathy and compassion. So may this season again renew our energy and our commitment through the Spirit of Jesus to stand in solidarity with those around us that need us. Until, as in the words of Isaiah, every wilderness and every dry land be made glad and every desert rejoice. And all see the glory of our Lord and the majesty of God. So as God gave his best, may we also give each other our best. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. God bless you.
Things are broken, things are shared, things are carried, hearts bow in prayer. It is grace, only grace, that brings us here, holds us together here. It is grace, only grace, that brings us here, holds us all together. Things are dying, things are torn, hope is growing and burdens borne. It is grace, only grace, that brings us here, holds us together here. It is grace, only grace, that brings us here, holds us all together.
Amen. Later that night, I held an atlas in my lap and ran my fingers across the whole world and whispered, "Where does it hurt?" It answered, "Everywhere. Everywhere. Everywhere."
It is great.
Hallelujah, Emmanuel, Christ has come to earth to dwell. Hallelujah, Emmanuel, go to all the world and tell. Shepherds lay out in the field, in the night under the stars, peaceful and still. Then all the heavens began to rain, and they heard the angels sing. Christ has come to earth to dwell. Hallelujah, Emmanuel, go to all the world and tell.
On a cross so dark and cold, Jesus gave all he had, body and soul. They laid him in a mortal grave, but he arose on the third day.
Hallelujah, Emmanuel, go to
Greetings to all my friends and fellow believers, together with the audience around the world, anticipating the coming of Jesus as we celebrate the birth of the Christ child. While we all prepare our lives for this magnificent celebration, may our hearts and home display Jesus in the way we live and interact with our fellow man. As the angels brought the good news to the shepherds so long ago, I pray that you hear the good news and embrace the true message of Christmas fully, with conviction and earnest preparation for the final coming of Jesus Christ. In the first chapter of John, we hear a voice calling, "Clear the way for the Lord in the wilderness. Make smooth in the desert a highway for our God. Let every valley be lifted up, every mountain and hill be made low, and let the rough ground become a plain, and the rugged terrain a broad valley. Then the glory of the Lord will be revealed, and all flesh will see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken."
O holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope His power.
Dear friends, next is a reading of Isaiah 35 from Hutterites of all ages across our communities. The ancient prophets of Israel were God-empowered truth-tellers. They spoke God's word to both the rulers and people of Israel, and also to the surrounding nations. In the writings of the Old Testament prophets, hope, both of a better future and judgment on the present evil, are the two constant themes. There is never just a sharp edge of judgment, but also the balm and promise of hope that comes with faithfully responding to God. In Isaiah 35, we find a timeless passage that can serve as a beacon of light in the midst of darkness. In our own time, many continue to suffer in war, famine, and unrest. And although some of us are fortunate to live in places of peace and plenty, ancient Israel's struggles and dreams continue to speak to the deepest human longings. This oracle or prophecy presents a vision of the upcoming Messianic Age, a future of everlasting security, abundance, and shalom, peace. As followers of Jesus, we believe that Jesus did what we could not do ourselves. By his coming, he established his reign as shalom. Our world of sin and death has been interrupted by God's spirit of love, ever at work, paving the highway of peace. And yet the world remains plagued by war, famine, climate disasters, and communities not extending care and compassion as they ought to. It is in the face of all this that the hope of ancient Israel can inspire us. Isaiah 35 paints a picture of restoration and renewal. It reminds us that on God's highway, the wise and the foolish alike will find their way. This highway is not reserved for a select few, but a path open to all who seek refuge. Come, let us make our way on the highway of the Lord. May this reading resonate in our hearts, stirring us to action, bringing us a renewed sense of hope.
Wilderness and the dry land shall be glad.
And the desert shall rejoice and blossom.
Like the crocus, it shall blossom abundantly.
And rejoice with joy and singing.
The glory of Lebanon shall be given to it, the majesty of Carmel and Sharon.
They shall see the glory of the Lord.
The majesty of our God.
Strengthen the weak hands and make firm the feeble knees.
Say to those who are of a fearful heart,
be strong, do not fear, here is your God.
He will come with vengeance, with terrible recompense. He will come and save you.
Then the eyes of the blind shall be opened,
and the ears of the deaf unstopped.
Then the lame shall leap like a deer,
and the tongue of the speechless shall sing for joy.
For the waters shall break forth in the wilderness and streams in the desert.
The burning sand shall become a pool, and the thirsty ground springs of water.
The heart of jackals shall become a swamp,
and the grass shall become reeds and rushes.
A highway shall be there, and it shall be called the Holy Way.
The unclean shall not travel on it,
but it shall be for God's people. No traveler, not even shall go astray.
No lion shall be there, nor shall any ravenous beast come on it.
They shall not be found there, but the redeemed shall walk there.
And the ransom of the Lord shall return and come to Zion with singing.
Everlasting joy shall be upon their heads.
And they shall obtain joy and gladness, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away.
Bye.
We will sow His love where instruments of peace.
Greetings, everyone, who took the time to tune into this broadcast of wonderful songs and beautiful uplifting words to our Lord Jesus Christ. I would like to share a verse with you that has touched my heart this Christmas season, and I hope it touches your heart as much as it touched mine. You will find it in James chapter 1, verse 17. Every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, and comes down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation or shadow of turning. In this season of giving, let us remember the perfect gift we were given. Let us give perfect love. Let us show perfect love for each other with no variation. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Hallelujah. gathered on that day, and it still takes a wise man to bow before the King, to worship and adore Him more than any earthly thing. We offer up a sacrifice of praise for You today, and it still takes a wise man to pray. Yes, it still takes a wise man to bow before the King, to worship and adore Him more than any earthly thing. We offer up a sacrifice of praise for You today, and it still takes a wise man to pray. Lord, help me be a wise man today.
I'll be reading a poem by Katharina Regina von Greifenberg. Auf Christus Wundergeburt. Wie hat die Allheit sich in dieses Nichts begeben? Die Unaussprechlichkeit, so alles spricht aus. Macht die Schwachheit dann zu ihrer Allmacht aus? Will den Fußschemel sie zu Ehrenthron erheben? Der Unbegreifliche will auf den Händen schweben, der Erd und Himmel regt mit seines Donners Braus. Was mehr, das Meer verfließt mit seines Atems Saus, denkt in den keuschen Glas der Jungfrau Leib zu leben. Das Wort und Weisheitkraft, das ganze Sein geboren, lässt aus dem Staub der Zeit selbst gebären sich. Gott wird ein Mensch, auf das der Mensch sei unverloren. Sein elendes Abgrundstand, ehrt Himmel heben dich. Lass allen Hoffartspracht, weil Demut sie erkoren, der Höchste folgt, sie sei die Hoheit wesentlich.
Till I wake up, until I wake up.
Love from the forest or gold from the oppose the love that made it. Each might deny the source that gave it worth. When underneath the star was born a Savior, the Spirit God could now be touched and see. His mission was to listen to his Father and grow among the lost he would redeem. One hope remains, one unyielding flame. Christ with us, Christ with us, our glorious hope. Obedience would bring him to his scoffers, subjected to the shame of their design. But nonetheless his flesh as bread was offered to hearts that hungered more for his demise. This hope that lay entombed among the hopeless at break of day awoke and drew a breath. In full display God's power there was witnessed as we beheld the conqueror. All the earth will bow and sing.
Here in our part of Manitoba, we have a long-standing Christmas tradition, the McGregor and North Norfolk Area Christmas Cheer Board's annual Carol Fest fundraiser. The locals gather to sing seasonal carols and songs, and to open our hearts to give generously so that each family in our area can have a happy Christmas with enough to eat and a gift for every child. Last year, we came up with the idea of organizing a community choir in the area using the Baker Choir as a core. So, in early November, the Baker Choir was joined by some of the finest singers from our local area. I was flabbergasted to discover that the age range of this choir was 13 to 93. For the rest of the month, we met regularly for rehearsals and also shared a meal. We performed at the annual McGregor Carol Fest on December 3rd under the bold and intense gaze of the local high school mascot. It was a wonderful coming together of Hutterites and neighbors to enrich our local community. In a time when we're often tempted to stay in our bubbles and comfort zones, this choir gives me hope that there's a deeper, richer life to be found when we share our gifts with each other. This year, I had hopes of producing a top-notch, snazzy recording for this compilation, but I find no greater joy than sharing this makeshift recording of Hutterites not just singing for their neighbors, but with their neighbors. I hope you find it as meaningful as I do. God bless you.